Libyan rebels are celebrating the storming of Colonel Gaddafi's compound in Tripoli. The leader says abandoning his former haven was a tactical move.
It was a brutal 40-year dictatorship brought to a crashing end by an overwhelming display of people power and courage. 6 months after the fight to oust Gaddafi began, an act of defiance Libyans never dreamed possible. Rebel fighters met little resistance as they smashed their way inside Gaddafi's fortified compound to proudly raise the flag and hopes of a democratic Libya. Those who funded Gaddafi's luxurious lifestyle moved in en masse to share in its spoils and make a mockery of one of his famous golf buggies. Some even made it into the lavish house of a son, Saadi al-Gaddafi, posing for photos and taking mementos.
Probably his daughter. I don't know, he's probably some famous guy. Bless her. She's a lovely girl. Her father's not.
In a country that for so long banned free speech, reporters beamed live pictures from Gaddafi's backyard.
We're in front of his compound. And where is he?
There was no sign of the colonel, feeding fears he fled the country weeks ago. Another theory is that the now bearded colonel is hiding in a maze of underground bunkers, most likely in his hometown of Sirte. Rebels have renamed Green Square Martyrs Square.
Thank you, Obama. Thank you, Mr. President Obama.
But Gaddafi troops still occupy the port and surround the main media hotel, with dozens of reporters trapped inside. Only 12 hours earlier, his son had boasted the Gaddafi family wasn't going anywhere. But with his reign and now his castle in ruins, this country's self-appointed king is effectively in exile. In Tripoli, Brett Mason, 10 News.
And Brett has just filed this update from the streets of Tripoli on what is an historic day for Africa.
Well, the fighting has continued for yet another day on the streets of Tripoli after an extraordinary night of celebrations, not only in the capital, but also in outlying cities. We drove through several of them and residents had gathered on the streets until the early hours. They were waving flags and watching live on television as the rebels achieved their ultimate goal of taking the fight directly to Colonel Gaddafi's house. Now, they only made it there due to the work of NATO airstrikes. And you can see here behind me, one of those airstrikes brought down this building just outside of town. The big question this morning, though, is where is Colonel Gaddafi? Many expected he would be hiding in that compound. That now appears unlikely. The rebels say the fighting will continue until Colonel Gaddafi is caught and brought to justice.